Surface chemistry part 3. We have already discussed adsorption and catalysis in part 1 and part 2 respectively. Now from picture it's very clear that these are all the examples of colloids in our real life. It means the next topic which we are going to deal with, it is nothing but colloid. Before starting colloid, let's recapitulate true solution, colloidal solution and suspension. This you have already read in your 9th class. They can be differentiated on the basis of size, filtrability, settling, visibility, separation and diffusion. You can quickly go through these points in order to recapitulate. We will study colloids in two parts, colloid 1 and colloid 2. Colloids 1, the learning objectives are classification of colloids, in which classification is done on the basis of physical state of dispersed phase and dispersion medium, nature of interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium, types of particles of the dispersed phase, cleansing action of soap and emulsion. What actually colloid is? A colloid is a homogeneous system in which one substance is dispersed, which is known as dispersed phase, as very fine particles in another substance called dispersion medium. Here, classification of colloids. Colloids are classified in three categories on the basis of number 1, physical state of dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Number 2, nature of interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Thirdly, types of particles of the dispersed phase. Let us study the classification of colloid on the basis of physical state of dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Here, this is the table. First, we will take example. The colored glasses or the gemstone. They are having dispersed phase as well as dispersion medium as solid and they are known as solid salt. Paint, cell fluids, they are known as sol and the dispersion phase and dispersion medium are solid and liquid respectively. In case of smoke and dust, which is known as aerosol, the dispersed phase is solid, dispersion medium is gas. Cheese, jellies we usually eat, they are known as gel and dispersed phase is liquid. Dispersion medium is solid. This is the most important one, emulsion. Emulsion in this dispersed phase as well as dispersion medium, both are liquid. Examples are milk, hair cream, butter. Fog, mist, cloud, insecticide sprays. They are known as aerosol. Here, the dispersed phase is liquid and dispersion medium is gas. We can see that smoke and dust are also known as aerosol, but the difference lies in the dispersed phase. In case of smoke, it is solid, whereas in case of fog, it is liquid. Next comes pumice stone or foam rubber. They are known as solid sol. Here, dispersed phase is gas, dispersion medium is solid. Again, we can see colored glasses, they are also known as solid sol, but the dispersed phase and dispersion medium both are solid here. And the last type is known as foam, and we come across froth, whipped cream, soap, lather in our day-to-day life. Where dispersed phase is gas, dispersion medium is liquid. classification of colloid on the basis of nature of interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Broadly, it is classified into two groups, lyophilic colloid, lyophobic colloid. Lyophilic colloids form a strong interaction between the dispersed phase and dispersion medium, whereas lyophobic colloids form little or no interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Lyophilic colloids are solvent loving, whereas lyophobic colloids are solvent hating. Some examples are starch, gum, protein, soap, etc. of lyophilic colloid. And for lyophobic colloid, metals such as platinum, gold, etc., metallic sulfides and hydroxides, sulfur, etc. If the two phases are separated by using any separation technique, the salt can be recreated simply by mixing the phases. That is why lyophilic colloids are known as reversible colloids. Whereas, once the particles are separated, they cannot be incorporated back into the salt by means of simple remixing. Thus, they are known as irreversible, and lyophobic colloids are irreversible in nature. The point to be remembered, lyophilic colloids are solvent loving, lyophobic colloids are solvent heating, lyophilic colloids are reversible, whereas lyophobic are irreversible. Third way of classifying colloid is on the basis of types of particles of the dispersed phase. Broadly, they are classified into three categories: multimolecular colloids, macromolecular colloids, associated colloids. Multimolecular colloids. On dissolution, a large number of atoms or smaller molecules of a substance aggregate together to form species having size in the colloidal range, that is diameter less than 1 nanometer. Example, gold salt and sulfur salt. Macromolecular colloids. Macromolecule in suitable solvent form solution in which the size of macromolecule may be in colloidal range. For example, starch, cellulose, protein, enzymes, polythene, nylon, polystyrene, synthetic rubber, etc. Now, the last one is associated colloids. At low concentration, they behave as normal strong electrolyte, but at higher concentrations exhibit colloidal state properties due to formation of aggregated particles which are known as micelle. For example, soap and detergent. We have studied about associated colloids. There are two important terms associated with associated colloids: Kraft's temperature and critical micelle concentration. Let us try to understand what Kraft's temperature is. The Kraft's temperature is defined as the minimum temperature at which ionic surfactant forms micelle, or the formation of micelles takes place only above a particular temperature, that is known as Kraft's temperature. The critical micelle concentration, also known as CMC, is the surfactant concentration at and above which micelles are formed, or the formation of micelles takes place only above a particular micelle concentration called critical micelle concentration. Micelle formation. We need to understand what soap is. Soap is the sodium or potassium salt of fatty acid and may be represented as RCOO negative Na positive. For example, sodium stearate, which is represented as CH3CH2 whole 16 COO negative Na positive. When dissolved into water, it dissociates into RCOO negative and Na positive ions. Now, the RCOO negative ion consists of two parts: long hydrocarbon chain, which is also called nonpolar tail, which is hydrophobic or water repelling in nature, and a polar group COO negative, which is also known as polar head. It is hydrophilic in nature and water loving. From this figure we can understand very well, this green arrow is pointing towards the hydrophilic end represented by COO negative, and this pink color represents the hydrophobic tail of stearate ion. At higher concentration, that is CMC, RCOO negative ions form an aggregate of spherical shape with the hydrocarbon chain pointing towards the center and the COO negative part facing outward on the surface of the sphere. This aggregate is called ionic missile. It may have as many as 100 ions. From this figure, things will be very clear. The first one shows arrangement of stearate ion on the surface of water at a low concentration of soap, and the second one, arrangement of stearate ions inside the bulk of water, that is ionic missile, at critical missile concentration of soap. Cleansing action of soap. We have already discussed about the missile formation. Now, the cleansing action of soap is due to the formation of missile by the soap molecule in such a way that the hydrophobic part is in the oil droplet and the hydrophilic part projects out. Since the polar group interacts with water surrounded by soap ion, is pulled from the surface and pulled into the water. As a result, cleaning takes place. We will try to understand with the help of this diagram. The pink arrow points towards the grease present on the cloth. This green arrow points towards the stearate ion arranging around the grease droplet. Here we can see that the hydrophobic end is getting arranged on the grease droplet. Now this blue arrow shows grease droplets surrounded by the stearate ions, that is missiles form. Now missile is formed and the grease particle, it gets broken up and it is washed away by the water. Hence the cleaning takes place. While studying the classification of colloid on the basis of phase of dispersed phase and dispersion medium, we came across a type of colloid known as emulsion. Emulsions are colloidal solutions in which both the dispersed phase and dispersion medium are liquid. Emulsions are broadly classified into two types: oil in water emulsion, water in oil emulsion. Types of emulsion. With the help of this diagram, we will try to understand the types of emulsion. Blue color represents water. Orange color represents oil. In the first case, we can see water is the dispersed phase, whereas oil is acting as dispersion medium. So this is water in oil emulsion. Whereas in the second case, dispersed phase is oil and dispersion medium is water. So this is oil in water emulsion. Here, cream. This is an example of oil in water, whereas butter is an example of water in oil. Now, we need to understand few terms like emulsification, emulsifier, and de-emulsification. Emulsification is the process of dispersing one miscible liquid into another miscible liquid, or we can say it is the process of making emulsion. Emulsifiers, it is compound or a substance that acts as stabilizer for emulsion. Now, the commonly used emulsifiers for oil in water emulsions are protein, gum, soap, etc. Whereas the commonly used emulsifiers for water in oil emulsions are heavy metal salts of fatty acids, long chain alcohol. Now, de-emulsification. As the name says, it is just opposite of emulsification. It means in de-emulsification, it is the process of breaking of crude oil emulsion into water and oil phase. Now, here are some emulsions encountered in everyday life. Pond's cream, Sedgwick cool gel, this is the hair gel. Ice cream, it is also emulsion. Butter, this is also an emulsion. Milk that we drink, this is also emulsion, where both dispersed phase as well as dispersion medium are liquid. So, I hope things are clear to you. Thank you so much. Keep learning. Stay safe. Stay healthy.